Hi neighbor, my name is Hannah and welcome back to my channel, Pretty Hippie Me. Today, I am going to be looking at some spring 2020 fashion trends and giving you my thoughts on them. I'm consulting some expert resources, namely Vogue Magazine online, MaryClaire.com, and Harper'sBazaar.com to figure out what are the top spring 2020 trends and answering basically two questions. One, are they plus size friendly? And two, what are my personal opinions on those trends? If I don't like a particular trend, that doesn't mean it's a bad trend. I just have a particular style that I like. So I have my resources pulled up and let's get started. Trends have always fascinated me because, like, how do they all happen to send so many similar elements down the runway at the same time? I never really get it. But what's interesting to me is all three of the magazines I'm consulting online have a lot of similarities, but Marie Claire pulls a lot of trends out from the runway shows that are different from Harper's Bazaar and Vogue. I have no idea how this works, but I find it fascinating. So the first big trend that all three resources pulled out is vests. They're rather menswear inspired, a little looser rather than like a real like waist cinching tight vest. It's kind of also echoed in Marie Claire pulling out a trend of wearing corsets. I feel like those two kind of go hand in hand with the emphasis on the waist. I do think that this is pretty plus size friendly. I think it depends on how you want to wear it. Do you want to go more menswear inspired and oversized, or do you want to keep it more trim and tailored? But I don't think there's any reason that this couldn't be friendly to plus size women. As for me and my personal style, I do love a good vest. I haven't had an opportunity or a reason to wear one for a while. I feel like I don't see them in stores, but maybe now I will soon. I like giving a good, like, cinched waist silhouette going on. That's not exactly what I'm seeing with the trend. It's a lot of menswear shapes and oversized, but I get to wear it the way that I want, so I'm gonna go a little more shapely if I find a vest in store that I like. Another more agreed upon trend is leather for the spring. It's another trend where I think it could totally work for plus size women. I don't see why not. There are plenty of ways that you can wear leather and it can be totally flattering, but what I don't really get is why leather in the springtime? Because it's such a heavier, warmer fabric that's really better for protecting against the cold. And I feel like you'd really need to balance it out. Like if you're wearing a leather skirt, you'd really need to balance it out with a very light shirt so that you don't overheat. Maybe that's more of a plus size person problem to think about. But it just kind of seems common sense that I'm not going to wear a lot of leather in warm weather. However, I do really like the idea of a leather vest. Maybe I can combine the both of those trends. That would be fun. Another agreed upon trend is bright highlighter neon colors. So I think this trend has more to do with your skin tone than your body type. I think that this can totally work for plus size or tiny women, whatever size you are, you can wear whatever color you want, you know? I don't think that neon highlighter colors look very good on me personally. I have kind of like warm undertones. I'm an autumn. Earth tones really work for me better than like super bright colors. But I think if you have the right skin, you have the right undertones for it, like anybody can wear neon highlighter colors. So I appreciate that. Another trend that's happening is kind of a texture trend with crochet and raffia. I really love crochet personally. I don't really love raffia as much, but I'd be willing to see how it looks and how it feels. I love texture. I'm all about texture in my style. So if I like how it feels, I'm willing to try anything out. I think again, because we're just talking about a fabric, this is totally plus size friendly. I don't know how it could not be. The only thing is just that crochet tends to be a little bit sheer in a way because it's a little bit of a loose knit, so there's like little holes and you can see through. So you have to decide your comfort level with that. Or if you're someone who's more into like a crocheted cardigan or long vest or something kind of flowy that doesn't have to have a sheerness element to it at all. But I think this is perfectly plus size friendly and I personally really love it because I love talking texture. Going back quickly to the corset thing, this spring is also going to have a lot of kind of what I'll call like undergarment elements to it. There's a lot of popularity with bra tops, wearing bralettes and bra tops under your blazers, wearing sheer fabrics, and again, corsets. We're going like sexy, but trying to make sexy everyday and professional with wearing it under a blazer. this, in terms of being plus size friendly, I think this is much more of an opinion-based thing. I think it has to do with your personal preference, your personal body type, and your personal confidence with letting some skin show. For me personally, if I'm going to wear something sheer, it's for a night out, a weekend, it's definitely not to work. If it is to work, I definitely need to wear a high cami with it. It's not the most professional look in my opinion. The bralette with the blazer confuses me. I have no idea where I would wear that because I'm not a person in the springtime, in the warm weather, to wear a blazer out at night. And if I'm wearing a bralette, I'm not wearing a bralette to work. So I'm just more confused by what to do with that trend, Marie Claire. Like, how am I supposed to wear that in my day-to-day life, Marie Claire? With the sheer fabrics, I feel like you can make it work for you and make it work for your body by layering or not layering, however you choose. With bralettes and bra tops, you can wear a bralette or a bra top with some high-waisted shorts, high-waisted pants, high-waisted skirt, or you can go normal if you like to show off your midriff. For me, in terms of what I would wear, it's definitely a weekend look. I like to do a bralette or a bra top with a high-waisted skirt or something. But yeah, with these undergarment element types of trends, corsets, bralettes, with a blazer or no blazer, I think it's very interpretive and very personal. I'm not necessarily going to rush and jump for these trends. Bralettes have been around for a while, and it looks like they're here to stay, so that might be something worth investing in, finding some bralettes or bra tops that you really love, high quality, the right amount of coverage for your confidence. But I can't really say that it's the most universal look. I think there are a lot of women who would not be comfortable with it, whether you're plus-sized or not, and, you know, to each their own. Another really agreed upon trend is 70s shirts. What I mean by that is like wide lapels that like V out to here, like kind of how my dress is doing, but like out to here, and button down and lots of fun, crazy prints. I do not love this trend. It is not something that I'm personally going to go buy because I hate wearing button up shirts. I feel like they never fit me, they never close properly over my bust, and they're super uncomfortable. So in terms of my opinion, I don't like it. But in terms of it being plus size friendly, I don't see why not. But again, you have to really find the right shape and style of button-up shirt so that you're not experiencing like gaping. I don't know, I guess it's another like menswear inspired element, and it's fine. It doesn't really excite me, and it's not my style of something that I'd really like run out to get. The last trend that everybody was kind of agreeing on is wearing shorts professionally, like with blazers. And this one to me is a little bit unclear because it ranges anywhere from like a short, like palm length short, to being like a culotte, like below your knee. All of that is kind of in this trend together, and all still being worn with a blazer. So I don't know if they're trying to imply that it's professional to wear shorts to work. I think that that really depends on where you're working. I've never been told, hey, you can wear shorts to work, even if they're a professional fabric. So to me, it's not really a very wearable trend unless you really like a professional looking culotte. You might be able to get away with wearing a culotte to work. I think that it's fine in terms of being plus size friendly, as long as they make them in our sizes. You know, it's just many different lengths of shorts in professional fabrics. But in terms of being practical and wearable in any way, no. I don't think so. And I don't think that I'm really gonna run out and try to make this work for me. I'm not really into it. Now I'm going to move on to some trends that were each only highlighted by one of the three sources that I'm using, and just give you a hot take on it, because if everybody's not in agreement, I don't really have to agree either. Harper's Bazaar is saying that hot pants are coming back, they're mini shorts, and it's springtime. Yes, that kind of seems like a given. It can be plus size friendly, depending on how long you like your shorts. As soon as I look at hot pants, I just think of chub rub. So for me personally, it's not on my go-to list for the spring and summer, but if you have really nice toned legs, go for it, show them off. Harper's Bazaar is also pointing out like tiered skirts, and it comes across in a couple of ways, one being like floofy ruffled tiers, and another tiered shape being more of like a peasant skirt where there's layers but they're all sewn together top to bottom. Neither of these really excites me. I think because the fabrics are kind of funny, like the fabrics for the ruffled skirts are a little bit stiff, which seems not super flattering to me. And ruffled skirts in general, like I already have big hips, so I don't need to add more volume there. And then peasant skirts never fit me appropriately. There's like 3 tiers in a row, and that first tier always just like sticks way too tight to my hips, no matter what size I get. It has to be way too big for my waist for it not to like stick to my hips. So as much as I do enjoy like a boho style, I don't enjoy peasant skirts. Another singular trend, 60s wallpaper. Basically, it just means like 60s and 70s big, bold, crazy prints. This, you know, perfectly plus size friendly because it's just a print. I'm not really gonna run out and get it because I'm very picky with my prints, and so far I'm not really seeing any from this trend that I really love. There's also a bit of a feather trend Harper's Bazaar is pointing out. I don't love how feathers look. They're perfectly plus size friendly. Again, anybody can wear feathers. It's just a texture, it's a fabric, but I don't care for it myself. Harper's Bazaar also points out polka dots in a section called Les Polka Dots, because they're trying to be French or something. Polka dots, again, it's a print, it's a fabric. You can wear it in a ton of different ways. I don't love polka dots, so I'm not gonna run for it myself. One thing I do love that Vogue pointed out is a trend that they're calling blank slate, but it's like this all white, ethereal, drapey, long, flowy kind of look, which that just speaks volumes to my fantasy-loving hippie soul. I would love to just all day, every day, everywhere, just wear a long, white, flowing thing that I can whirl around in and feel like Galadriel, but like before she goes crazy. Close to my heart, personally, I love it. And I think it's perfectly plus-size friendly. Again, there's plenty of ways to wear white, drapey, long, flowy things besides a wedding dress. Vogue also pointed out some cutouts. I love me a good cutout, I'm not gonna lie. So personally, I'm really into it. And it can be plus-size friendly, but I think you really need to rely on trendy plus-size brands to give you the right cutout in the right place that's not going to conflict with your undergarments. Because, you know, we need to wear supportive bras, we might like to wear shapers daily, we have some things going on to keep us looking tight and smooth and snatched. The cutout being in the wrong place can kind of conflict with that for sure, but especially with spring and summer coming, I love cutouts. I wouldn't necessarily wear it to work, but great for the weekends and night outs, and I think that if you find the right brand, put with the right cutout in the right place, you can feel comfortable wearing one at any size. Vogue also says that trench coats are in for the spring, like they are every spring. So, thank you, Vogue. Sure, I don't have anything against a trench coat. I think it can work for every body, every size. It's boring, but okay, trench coats. Vogue is also pointing out that people are still working with denim in fun ways. It's a kind of a broad trend that they're calling out. It's not even like they're saying wide leg denim or like denim shirts or something. They're just saying fun denim. So, sure, I mean, because it's so broad, it can work for any body, any type. It's a fabric, but I wish that it was a little bit more specific what exactly they mean. Vogue is calling out some tropical prints, especially there's a majority of green tropical prints going on. I like a tropical print depending on the print. I like it in small doses. Sometimes tropical prints can be really overwhelming. So in terms of it being good for plus size, sure, you know, it's a print, it's a fabric. If you like it, you like it. I think the only thing that can change with being plus size is choosing the right proportion of the print. With a bigger body, I think maybe get a print with larger images in the print. Like, there's a proportionality there. And it's another trend that I'm like, that's in every spring, isn't it? But, you know, it's back again. Vogue is also pulling out a 70s trend, and yeah, I can see that. It's present in the shirts I was mentioning, I think in the vests, in the menswear as well. It's another really broad category where, like, if you want to wear something 70s inspired, sure, it can totally work for a plus size person, because that's a very wide category of things, so something in that category can work for a plus size person. I really like the boho side of the 70s and 60s, so in terms of my own opinion, I like parts of it. Marie Claire is pulling out some drawstring details as one of their trends. I think that drawstrings, when placed appropriately, can be very flattering on a plus-size body. It just has to, like, be in the right place and working in the right purpose. I think that they can make some really cool details and they can be perfectly plus size friendly. I think if they happen to be on something that I already like, then cool. But I'm not going to be like, I'm going to go shopping for some drawstring things today. I feel like that's a very kind of specific thing to go shopping for and to be a trend. Marie Claire is also pointing out some sky-high side slits on skirts. I do love that. However, I think it has to be placed properly so that it doesn't turn into a flashing situation by accident in the wind. And that's another one where, in terms of being plus size friendly, I always wear like shorts and shapers underneath my skirts. If the side slit is too sky high, then my shaper is gonna be out for people to see. So if you have some other anti-chub rub solutions so that I can wear this trend without showing off my shaper, let me know. So in theory, I like it, but in practice, I don't know if it'll work. Last but not least, Mary Claire is pointing out day to night sequins. I'm kind of surprised that they're finding that trend because the other articles didn't mention it, and in the many photos with the other trends, I didn't see really any sequiny stuff going on. But if they say it's happening, I trust Marie Claire. Again, sequins are a texture, almost like a printer pattern. I don't think that there's anything that's not good for plus size about sequins. I'm not a huge sequin person. It's a very like more of a night out, possibly can work in formal wear, kind of fancy attire kind of thing. But I think that it can work for a lot of people. If you have a more glam kind of style, then go for it. It's not my cup of tea personally on a day-to-day basis. So yeah, those are the spring 2020 trends according to Vogue, Mary Claire, and Harper's Bazaar. I hope that you found those helpful and informative. I hope that you already have some things in your closet that you can use to start wearing these trends, or you can use this information to inform your shopping. I was surprised and happy that there was only a couple of trends where I felt like size really mattered at all. The bra tops, the sky-high side slits, and the cutouts, where just you need to find the right brand that's selling you the right item with the right type of support, or the right placement of the cutout, that type of thing. But all of the other trends were really pretty much just fabrics and prints, which always can work on anybody, just depends on if you personally like it and how you style it. So for that reason, I'm really happy with these spring 2020 trends, and I'm looking forward to wearing some of them, not all of them, but some of them. Let me know which ones you're interested in wearing below. Let me know your thoughts on all of them, you know? And while you're there commenting below, I hope that you like this video, subscribe to my channel, and set your notifications to all. My channel is growing slowly but surely, and I would really love to have you as part of our little neighborhood that we're forming here. Thank you so much for watching. Your support really means so much to me. Thank you for spending your time with me. So much love. Bye.